Amy Reichen, and I'm in Toronto, Canada. We're going to be visiting the Toronto Botanical Gardens and the Allen Gardens Conservatory.
Public gardens are shaped by the people who interact with and within them. They are sites of education, community gathering, and scientific expertise. At the Toronto Botanical Garden, you can observe the variety of techniques humans have used for centuries to control and foster plant growth. In this knot garden, plants are meticulously pruned and shaped. Raised planting beds are featured in the herb and kitchen gardens. This structure is reminiscent of stone enclosures developed by the Romans, who covered beds with flat mica sheets to create warm environments. Centuries later, greenhouses were developed. Building up the landscape is another technique used to control plant growth. At this botanical garden, a berm was built to separate the garden from the parking lot. The berm is built from brick fragments and recycled bottles and is home to perennials that can survive the sun and wind conditions. In addition, plants can be trained to trellises and soil amended to improve growing conditions. Across town at the Allen Gardens Conservatory, the dome of the Central Palm House, built in 1910, is a reminder that conservatories are home to plants that have been uprooted and moved across the globe. For example, in the warmth of a conservatory, cacti and bromeliads grow year-round in a city with winter temperatures that average slightly below freezing. Conservatories also make visible the techniques humans use to control the growth of plants. For example, topping trees such as this cypress or forcing bulbs such as tulips and daffodils to bloom ahead of their natural schedule. At the Children's Conservatory attached to the Allen Gardens Conservatory, students plant seeds that sprout in the warm environment. While I've reported on public conservatories, wealthy individuals have built conservatories for their own enjoyment. Here in Toronto, the Casa Loma Estate features a conservatory with a stained glass dome. Tropical plants and bulbs are heated by steam pipes buried in the planter boxes, demonstrating yet another technique humans have developed to alter plants' growing cycles.
Signing off from Toronto.